When I was a project manager, I was efficient, highly competent, and very task-focused. I did not want to hear about people's weekends because that didn't get the job done, right? Just didn't matter. And I figured people should understand that. We're at work, right? We're there to work. So one of the things, though, that ended up as a project manager in a software company that made software for banks, I was one of the few people who actually worked at a bank. So I also explained a lot of things to people, and I eventually became a senior trainer and the training manager. And I used that same project manager zeal with all of my training classes, especially in terms of time. I became known as the Dragon Lady. This was a nickname that I wore with pride, and I nicknamed my dragon Ethelred. Because to me, class, that was your responsibility for the day, for the workday, and you needed to be there on time. I didn't see any issue with that. You need to be there on time, come back on time after lunch, after breaks. And I would do my part by getting you out on time. Seeing a theme here. And then I heard one lady, it was reported back to me, that one lady said she was so nervous about being back on time that she couldn't eat her lunch. And my first thought was annoyance. We have an hour. How long does it take her to chew? But then I thought, is that really how I want people to feel? Do I really want them to feel that nervous? So I kind of filed that away as a data point. Then an absolute chance of a lifetime came along. We got the chance to move to Germany through my husband's job. And they threw me a bone as a spouse and made me a part-time system administrator. Very low pay, very low expectations. The previous spouse had just done like filing. So the fact that I even knew, you know, a QWERTY keyboard, they considered a bonus. But there I was, and with no expectations, it didn't matter if things, at least it didn't matter for me, how things worked out. No one was going to blame me if they didn't go well. I didn't have to be the Dragon Lady. And people's weekends for a change were actually interesting. I mean, we're in Germany. Vineyards, castles, Switzerland, France. Yes, it was great. And as I kind of came out of that, ooh, we got to get it done, work shell, and I started to enjoy people. And they started to enjoy me. People said I was funny. And Ethelred, I could tell, was going pretty happily into hibernation. And that was just fine with me. I even became known as the Queen of Customer Service because our sysadmin shop was basically a help desk. So people would come in, they'd be a little sheepish. They didn't realize they'd done white letters on their white PowerPoint. And I would happily troubleshoot that. I didn't make them feel stupid. I ushered them out with a smile, and everybody loved me. People told me I was a joy to work with. That was not the word I had heard before. I continued to be the same good worker that I had been before. I continued to get things done, honor deadlines, all that kind of thing, but I did it without giving everybody else indigestion. And in that job, I actually got 2 promotions in that 3-year period because they could see what a good worker that I was. In our next assignment, I had the opportunity to move back into management. And I was nervous about that because I had come to kind of like this other Eva, who worked well with people that people liked, that when I needed that extra cooperation, I would get it. So I thought, can I do this? Can I move back into management and leave Ethelred snoring away in the den? Can I do that? So I came up with some strategies where I was able to do just that. And I would hear, you're the best boss I've ever had. It's a great thing. A great transformation to make. And it wasn't even always easy, and sometimes Ethelred came roaring out. And she tends to do that in airports. Airports and grocery stores, but I thought, okay, I can contain her. I can still be all about the task and the deadlines and such, and still be all about the people. And you can too. So I want to help you take that journey. Let's start now.